everyone. I hope you're doing well. Welcome to another episode of, I guess we'll call this Pizza with Rift. I have here a nice, fresh, warm, small pizza, half sausage, half pepperoni. So I'll be eating that, and you may notice that this time there is no buzzing sound. I have my in-ear mics, so you are going to get the very first person feel as far as the audio is concerned. And there's going to be eating sounds, of course, for those that may not like that. But I do it for those that do. And I also have a soda, Dr. Pepper. I don't drink soda too much, but I'll have a, one of these maybe once or twice a week. I don't drink it every day. We don't keep soda in our house. And I'm drinking soda not just for the young viewers out there who don't drink, for anyone who doesn't drink, regardless of age, and especially those that may be struggling with, alcoholism, who are on the wagon and things like that. So I want to also do it as a show of respect for those that are, that may not be able to watch my beer drinking videos or things like that. So this is just a casual rambling kind of thing. There's nothing really here except for some of the things I want to show you in coming up in future videos. That's part of the reason for this. I'm not good at just rambling all the time. So let me dig in here first. Give me a slice of this sausage pizza. And I am in southeastern Pennsylvania, west, in the western suburbs of Philadelphia. So there you go, there is a nice, let's see if my camera can focus on that, I hope. Sausage. It's got a nice, pizza has a nice, crust to it. Now, again, I don't think I've ever met a pizza that I don't like. I like to fold the pizza just because it's easier to eat, and I'm not trying to, it's a little cleaner to eat, I guess you could say. I thought it was going to all come pouring out there for a second. So I hope you're doing well, wherever you are, whoever you are. Again, thanks to longtime viewers, subscribers. those that have stuck around with me since the beginning, put up with some of my videos, even if you don't like their content and haven't unsubscribed. Thanks for the new subscribers and patrons. So to you, to your health, and all that. Cheers. Still get the carbonation from the soda. Add more crisp, kind of fizzy sound compared to beer suds, beer foam. Let me know what you like to drink with your pizza. Do you like soda, iced tea? I like soda with my pizza. I drink more iced tea than I do soda. There's something about the combination of the sweet soda. I would love to do love to do more eating videos of various foods. I'm a huge foodie. Shouting in the last pizza video. That was our neighbors. So, with that, as you can tell, I got here. Pumpkin that we picked up specifically for one hour binaural pumpkin relaxation, just like I did with the pineapple one. So somebody will be examining it, probably Corvus, maybe Professor, I don't know, but probably Corvus. be plenty of that going on. I wanted to show you that. That will be out by, you know, Halloween, the day of, the day after, something like that. All right, we're gonna have a nice slice of pepperoni. Do you like pepperoni? I'm not a huge fan of pepperoni or anything spicy, but I like the, you know, the pepperoni from time to time. And a nice little, the flavor, the kick. So. I don't normally wipe my mouth this often. This is just for the video. I also have post-apocalyptic letters from the apocalypse video coming up within about a week of this video. I have someone that actually sent in this, I get this bag, this satchel. It's pretty amazing. Of you that sent your letter in like a month or, God forbid, hope it's not 2 months ago, you know, please be patient. They're coming, so. And I also received this. Actually, purchased most of this. It's another backpack. Arts is the name of the person that I purchased this from. There's supposed to be a gas mask in here. I still have it. I just didn't put it back into the bag. I don't know what I did. But I got a new kind of gas mask, and they also sent some stuff to be used. Just the video. I love props. Now, the this is not really about me wanting stuff. This is all about props. How can I use this in various videos? Like I said, I'm not looking to get rich. All I'm looking to do is be able to try to do this full time, sustain myself, support my family. So we'll see what happens with Patron. I may need to seek other outlets, but we'll see where it goes. I'm, like I said, I don't wear a watch. I have one pair of jeans to my name. I'm just a regular, you know, guy with a car payment, things like that. We don't live in a big fancy house or anything, so. Anyway. What kind of pizza do you like? I'm hoping that if you're still watching this, you like pizza. Do you like plain? Do you like Sicilian style? I love Sicilian style. The thick crust. I also love strombolis, calzones, cheesesteaks, hoagies, Italian hoagie, which I should probably get one time. I think I did that once before, I'm not sure. Italian hoagie with extra sweet peppers, extra oil, salt, pepper, oregano, tomatoes, onions, lettuce, And it's gotta have the Capicola. I love that. Excuse me. Alright, let's get another sausage here. Slice. Forgetting. There you go. All right, I'll put it right there for you. So those videos are coming up. I was actually going to do a nature walkabout, non-speaking, just listen to the crunchy leaves. But it's raining. It's going to rain all weekend. This is Saturday, as I record this. And it's dreary out. So I didn't want to record that in those conditions. I like to have the sun out, you know. I'll be trudging through the mud. I received more letters for letters from the apocalypse. I still have more letters to get to, so I have like two or three videos still to come. Let me get a slice of this sausage. Did I show you this sausage slice? All right. My wife went on a business trip to Germany. And she said, "Do you want me to pick up anything for you? You know, for your videos?" And I said, "Candy." I wanted her to get of a hike for her to get there. And there is a Black Forest Cuckoo Clock official organization of folks that actually sell them. So there's actually one here in Pennsylvania that sells. It's an official part of this organization. They sell Black Forest cuckoo clocks, and I want one, so I'm gonna hopefully get one sometime next year. Because right now I'm focusing on masks for videos, but I want a cuckoo clock for the background with the pendulum, and then have the cuckoo chime at least just once during the video. And I want to get a chalet. I think they're called chalet. C-H-A-L-E-T. I don't think it's chalet. I don't know. It might be a German word, but I'm going to say chalet for now, or chalet, whatever. And with a cuckoo clock. It's almost like a cabin, a chalet, I guess is what it is, right? And some of them have the couple kissing, or the woodworker and that's what I want to get. I think I want to get one that you actually wind up, have to do it every day. So I asked my wife, if she could get a variety of candy. So she went to this one store, Karstadt. Not sure if you can see that. Anyway, K-A-R-S-T-A-D-T. You can actually go to their website, K-A-R-S-T-A-D-T.de. And I told her to get if she can get a variety of candy. In this store, or most German candy stores, I don't know, Kinder, they mostly sell Kinder. And as I understand it, and as she tells me, Kinder is like America's Hershey. Some Dickman's Choco Stroke chocolate covered marshmallow, apparently, and some chocolate motorcycles, and there's a whole bunch more. This is just less than, it's like a quarter of it. So thank you. that's really it. You know, that's just a little bit of a sneak preview in regards to the upcoming videos. Of course, there will be the annual Halloween candy eating video. So this will be like two candy eating videos. Most likely this year's Halloween candy eating video will have a special guest. I'm sure you can only imagine who that might be. And it won't be Corvus. Alright, I'm starting to get a little filled up here. So other than that, there's nothing really else. Nothing really else planned. The Phantom of the Opera video. That's on hold. After I read the book, I realized that the Phantom basically has like a skull face, almost, what's described in the book as Death's head, blazing eyes. So I want to get a mask, a silicone mask, and do a real proper Phantom of the Opera with a mask over the mask. Because in the book, the Phantom is not a normal looking guy. So if we're going to do it right, might as well go all out. Also, I want to get scleras. They're the contacts, the colored contacts that you get. They can be typical colors or they can be more artistic. But I don't wear contacts. And to get proper scleras, you need to give them your diameter and all this, as if you wore contacts. Which means I have to go out of the way. Not only just get an updated eyeglass prescription anyway, but then I have to pay, for a contact lens prescription just so I can get the you know, if I have astigmatism, which I think I do, the diameter and all that, so then I can order the sclares. So, only so much time to do everything. Now on a more real life note, I don't want to be a downer to anyone, but I was just thinking, if you drink soda, make sure that you limit your intake. With coffee. I drink coffee at my job, but in the morning I have a glass of water, then I have coffee, then I have water after that, water with my lunch, water in the afternoon, another cup of coffee, more water, and then water at night with dinner, and at home. So water is mostly water is mostly what the microphone, see if you like this. This is the most I've ever grown. I'm full. You know what I think we'll do? Save the Kinder stuff. We'll have one of these motorcycle candies. See if I can open this up quietly. You know, no one likes to hear anyone advice, things like that, but don't, when I say try to limit yourself, don't do it because I told you to do it. Think about it, you know. And if, just like anything in life, you know, be receptive, but don't dismiss something. Don't be too quick to accept it. Think about it. See if it fits your mentality, your lifestyle, your personal philosophy. But make sure you do drink more water than anything else. I mean, that's just a given, you know. All right, so they got this sealed up pretty good here. I'm trying to do this as quiet as possible. Let's move the pizza box down there out of the way a little bit. I'm not going to do a review. I was able to get the tape here. Man, they seal this like Fort Knox. Better be some good chocolate in here. So I'm not going to give this a proper review. I'm going to save that for the chocolate review tasting video. Need some chocolate. I always need dessert after a meal. It's a very bad habit. At night, I'm really good with what I eat anymore at night. Let's see if you like this sound. It's a solid piece of chocolate. Creamy. Oh, that's good. But I limit myself at night. My wife and I both do. In our early 30s. When we met almost 15 years ago, before we had our son, we ate terrible. We would have cheesesteaks at lunch, more junk at night, bowl of ice cream, you know, while watching a movie at 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock at night, just... We started to cook more vegetables, and our son was born, and we both made a conscious effort to make sure that he ate healthy, and we ate healthy, and ever since mid-2006, 2008, our son eats broccoli, just, you know, boiled or steamed, nothing on it. Most of his veggies, he's not a big fruit eater at all. Bananas, apples with peanut butter, he won't really eat much else fruit. He won't really eat. Much else. Of any other fruit. That was a hard sentence to say. We don't put a lot of butter on anything. He eats, we eat sweet potatoes, just boiled and put on a plate, or baked. We don't put a lot of butter on anything. He doesn't really drink much milk. I am somewhat of a opponent of milk, because if you think about it, we're not calves. Cow milk is meant for calves. Human milk is meant for humans. And then after we're done, water. I think, I'm not gonna get into a whole big thing, but I think there's something behind a lot of the illnesses, maybe diabetes, who knows, heart disease, somewhat attributable to milk, dairy. But, you know, it's hard to say. There's no manual. Human beings don't come with an instruction manual. There's nothing out there that tells us what we should eat. You know, you buy a computer, you buy a video game, you buy anything, and tells you how to use it, how to maintain it. Not us. We can only guess. And, you know, so. Chocolate. So, yeah, that's really it, you know. I had nothing really planned here, just wanted to talk with you, share some things that are coming up. Just kind of had this casual conversation. I would like to do these live, maybe, in the future. But the problem is time zones. So that's why. And plus the Google live stream thing isn't something I want to record on for a video that I want to keep. So, I'm not sure if I could use the binaural mics. But anyway. Oh, I'm also going to do a model building video. I haven't stopped doing traditional ASMR videos. So I'm going to do that as well. I think that's really it. I also want to thank those of you that send me personal messages on Facebook or YouTube. I read all the comments. I do take your constructive comments. Listen to those. When it came to that first playthrough of Alien Isolation, there's a little brightness issue. It was too dark. I got a new monitor. It's an Acer LCD. I think it's a 223, 1920 by 1080p. It's really bright, and I try to make sure that it's configured to match the video output, but my videos have been rendering a little darker than what I'm seeing on my monitor, so I just need to keep that in mind, and I have a way of taking care of that, so not a big deal, but some people have mentioned the brightness, the audio is a little bit too low on the game. So, I'll be adjusting that. But, I apologize if I don't get back to you right away. You know, full-time job. I come home, spend time with the family. Which just kind of mostly means my son. Now, it's real important. That reminds me, I'm going to do a fatherhood vlog before this year's over. But that's, family time is mostly, being with my son, paying attention to him. Our son. And then after that, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, unless me and the wife are doing something, then it's me time to create. So there's not much time between creating videos, spending an hour or two responding to comments and messages. So know that I do see your messages when you send them, for the most part. It just takes me a while to respond. Other than that, that's really it for this video. Stay tuned for Alien Isolation after this. Check out my Facebook page. I usually provide updates whenever I post a video there, a link on the Facebook page. I also also provide an update about upcoming videos and things like that. There's also going to be 1 hour binaural 1 hour binaural ASMR nut sack relaxation. That's probably going to contain every nut sack joke imaginable. Straight face and all. Hopefully I can pull that off. I'm not sure. I think it's probably Manly. I'm not sure if Manly is going to do it. Iggy, but I'm thinking I might take a more professional approach to it. Alright, folks, that's it for me. I want to thank you again for watching, for your support, for your comments, all of it. I hope you're staying well. I hope whatever you're dealing with, whether it's anxiety, addiction, whatever it might be, depression, that just take one step at a time, one moment to moment. Don't look at the next 5-10 years. One day at a time. And one day the next, and as you get through one moment, get through one day, you wake up the next day, remember that you're awake and you're alive. It's another chance to learn from your mistakes. Another chance to make more mistakes and learn from those as well. Another chance to right your ship and all that stuff. So I wish you all the best, especially those of you who are struggling with anything, you know, physically, mentally, etc. And a huge, huge shout out and thank you for those of you who are caregivers and take care of elderly, who work in, who volunteer, who work in soup kitchens, who take care of special needs kids. I don't know how you do it. I don't know if I would have the wherewithal and strength and fortitude. Something I would like to consider and think about in the future, especially volunteering in a soup kitchen. Huge, you are the heroes. You know, firefighters and police and those folks, of course, as well, military. But sometimes we forget about those who care for others. They were the unsung heroes. It's a lot of work, a lot of stress to take care of someone that can't bathe themselves, for instance. So, much love and respect to you folks. Really, I mean that. And for anyone that you know that takes care of someone like that. Alright, that's it. It's going to wrap it up. I'm probably going to eat another chocolate as we fade out here. So thanks as always for watching. Take care of yourself. And yeah, that's it. Peace and love.